Hello everyone, Goroblaze here. And I am already under attack. Anyways, how are you all doing? Welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda the Windraker. In the last episode, we were over at Windfall Island in that direction now. And we spent a long time in the auction house getting a bunch of cool stuff like pieces of hearts, a critical sale, treasure charts. And then we came over here and got a water upgrade from a great fairy. Hey there, what do you have to say? Ho ho, so that's how it works. Still enough, is that the diving crew over there? I can't tell. Don't really feel like pointing out the telescope to check. Because I have things to do, because we are going to walk down the whole island. Get into here. And completely botch that song. You saw nothing. Anyways, what we are going to do is we are going to head to the Wait. I need to get the fish for this island first. Yeah, fishy. There you are. Okay. You are a pain in the butt to find this time. Ooh, I need to buy some more baits. But for now, let's learn about the fairy island here. Oi, small fry! Yeah, I've heard. I'll take you on to chart and information about this island, and start by opening up your sea charts. And it's a heart. That little shopmaster on Windfall Island apparently got his hands on a truly amazing treasure. He calls it magic armor or something like that. It's a pretty cool magical relic, that's from what I've heard. If you want him to give it to you, try staring deep into his eyes and winning him over with flattery, Fry. And that's all the info I've got to offer. If you want to hear it again, yeah, usual policy. Okay, now that we've taken care of that, now I want to play the Ballad of Winds. And we are going to head down south to Outset Island. Because we're still ignoring the next dungeon and going on side quests here. Because there's a lot of stuff we can do. And let me tell you, being able to walk across the ocean like that is so nice now. See how there's Outset? Especially with the Swift Sail now, we can get everywhere with so much ease now. Anyways, one the King of Red Lions again, pretty much. We are here for pretty much one thing and one thing only. We are here to take care of the 10 Knights quests that we have obtained already. For if we go here to Orca, and his usual training, just go and pull them out. Darn, I keep doing that for some reason. I'll target him. And why, that is a knight's quest! How many of those do you have? Then I suppose the time has come for me to speak to you about the crest. The knight's crest. It is a symbol of a courageous knight. But not just anyone can gather them. No, it takes a soul who possesses not only power, but wisdom and courage as well. Ah, a nice trifecta. Any courageous soul who gathers 10 of these crests can learn a powerful new sword technique. Both my brother and I dreamt of learning this technique in our youth. We worked so hard to collect the crest. But it took many long years and adventures beyond count before we even approached finding 10 of them. and we both grew old. Hey, hey. These things come from Darknuts, which means you defeated a Darknut. That or you grapple hooked it, but seeing who you are, I believe you defeated a Darknut. And that's pretty impressive. Anyways, we are able to learn a new technique here. If we can master it. Very good, Link. Heed my words. And it is time to learn another new technique. Hold B to build up power and then release it. Come at me now, do it! And... oh, spin attack is a lot more powerful now. It's become the Hurricane Spin! You learn the Hurricane Spin. Hold B to build up your power and then release it to perform a rolling attack with your blade. Remember, it consumes magic power. That is a catch. Amazing thing. You did it. You have mastered the Hurricane Spin. At last, you have made our long-held dream come true. Oh, the joyful tears, they won't stop. I thought my tears had dried up long ago. There was nothing left for me to teach you. I am certain now that you will save your sister Aurel and bring her home to Outset. And there we go, that is pretty much all we came to Outset for. We now have a crazy new spin attack, which we shall, of course, use wisely and carefully. Death to everything! Ha ha! I couldn't resist. Also, yeah, you do get dizzy after using it. As you can see, some of my magic's been used up, but, I mean, if you have a ton of enemies, it's really useful. Especially for an upcoming boss. Okay. It's a few bosses from now, but still, it'll be useful. Okay, went and bought some bait from Beetle. Bought 2 servings of bait, which means I am now even poorer than I was before. But, anyways, it is time now to head out to the east. Have a few places I want to check out over here. You came before I was expecting you. This is a big octo. Yeah, these things... you want to either hit them with the boomerang... until their eyes have been taken out. And then, you can also alternatively hit them with the bombs. That does take less, fewer hits to do so. But, alright, shoot. In the back still has a hit left, doesn't it? There we go. But this octo has the least eyes of all the octos, so it's relatively easy to take down. The others, though, they have 8 and 12, so they'll be a lot harder of a fight, that's for sure. But for defeating this great octo, we rescue a great fairy. Oh, Waker of the Winds. Thanks to you, I have been freed from that beast's foul grasp. As thanks, I shall give you just a little of my power. And... with her power that she bestows upon us. Our magic power has increased. We now have twice as much as what we had before. So yeah, double the magic power now. Perfect to get just after unlocking the Hurricane Spin, right? In the place where the Wind God guides you, you will find one who can grant new powers to the hero, to the hero's bow that you wield. Power that can freeze fierce flames and melt the coldest ice. When you find you have need of such power, you must call upon the powers of the Wind God. May the winds of fortune always blow across your bow. And then she leaves. Well, oh, and then a boomerang comes back to us after all that, okay. Well, there we go, we have twice the magic power now. Oh, so we do have the power of the Wind God. However, we cannot quite get what the Great Fairy was telling us about. Now, what we do have here is we have one of the reefs here, the Great Reefs. There are six of them everywhere. And just for a moment. Oh, come back here. There we go. And sunk. No, no, I'm trying to get out of that. Ew. It's pushing me. Okay. Oh, the rupee disappeared. Okay. So, this is one of the reefs. Basically, what we need to do is go in and destroy all of the cannons inside. This, okay, it's two eye reefs, so it's not that bad. Reef not active? Oh, hello there. First try! Okay, what stuff do we have in here that's so suddenly shown up? You know what, I'm broke, so I'll take that. But I don't quite remember this. I remember there being cannons and stuff I had to destroy. First try again! I just love the look on Link's face. It's like, oh? What is this? What's in here? Now the purple rupee. And let me guess, using my psychic powers, purple rupee. Hooray! Well, okay. Suppose these cannons just don't become active until... I mean, I could have sworn they became active sooner. Whoops. Well, that's just a disappointment. Well, I suppose we'll be back here later then. Unfortunately. Well, at least we got some money. Now, where's the fish? Hoi, small fry! Yeah, yeah, usual stuff. Two-eye reef. I tell you, lately no one has been around these waters. Lately no one around these waters has seen the beautiful fairy who bestows magic power. She used to live here, Fry. Oh, anyone ever sees any more of these other big otters that have been appearing lately? Maybe they scared her off. Oh no, I sure hope they didn't eat her. And sadly, we already took care of all that, so his information was kind of useless. Oh well. Anyways, onward. Oh, darn it. This is bad. Okay. No. No, Link, get back in the boat. That's not what I wanted. Oh, I'm so... Link? L target. No target. I am so glad you don't get knocked out of the boat when you take a hit anymore. Okay. Now, can I please salvage? There we go. Whoop-dee-doo. Now, what is in this that we just pulled up? We get a piece of heart. Congratulations, Sean, you managed to find the treasure chart The you managed to find the treasure without even opening up the treasure chart. Well, hey, we got a piece of heart at least. Speaking of which, I should probably go and open all of these up. Yeah, we just got treasure chart 15. There, we're going to open up all the treasure charts that we... I guess I got you already. Okay. Open up all these. That way you can see some of these. That's Tingo's map. Did I ever show that one? I don't remember. Well, that's Tingo's map. Beetle's map. We've already seen this. And back to treasure chart 1. Okay. Well, anyways, these islands look fairly odd, do they not? Anyways, Fish Guy was right over here. He moved away from the island. What a jerk. He was on the other side when I approached. Okay, well. There we go. We can learn about these real islands now. Usual stuff, da da da. And, appropriately enough, given the shape, these are the Angular Isles. Some of the smallest islands in the entire Great Sea. Northeast of here is the Forest Haven. They say a truly unique kind of firefly is indigenous to that place. You heard of it, Smallfly? It emits bursts of light in 7 colors. Supposedly it's as beautiful as a rainbow. If you want to capture one, though, you best have a bottle to keep it in. And that's all the info I've got to offer. If you want to hear it again, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, yeah, I know. Working on getting the other empty bottles, but one I can't get for a little bit, and the other one is expensive to buy. Anyways, what we want to do is get off here at this island. Well, it's now time to explore this bizarre place and try to find the way up. We have found the way up. Oh, hey. Well, that was cool, but I want to go and pull this out. No, pull it out. It looks like I can pull it out. I miss it. Oh. Silly me. I'm supposed to just push this. I mean, I jumped it, but just for convenience sake and showing what you're supposed to do. There you go. And now pull this out. That falls. Now I slowly climb up here. And upon reaching up to the top of this place, a blue choo-choo appears. And with that, we get some blue choo jelly. There are only about, if I recall correctly, 15 blue choo-choos in the entirety of the Great Sea. You need to collect those jellies, because if you do, you'll be able to get the ultimate potion from the potion shop by doing so. It's not as ultimate as the elixir soup, but you can have multiple bottles filled with them. That said, the elixir soup's a lot better. But I will be getting all the blue choo-choos and the magic cures. But this is the first one here at the top of Angler Isle, and also, inside this treasure chest, we get another piece of heart! And we now have obtained yet another life container, another heart container. Let's see here. We also, as you can see over there, have a secret cave. That we just need to use the Deku Leaf to get over to. Well, I suppose potentially swimming the waters all the way up to the very top, but we're just going to use a Deku Leaf. We have so much magic now anyways, it doesn't really matter. Link, get back on the island, Link. I know I pushed the wrong button. There we go. So, funny story. The guide I was looking at to double check to make sure where things were and to double check to make sure I could do things at the proper time, it kind of neglected to mention I need an item that I don't have yet, and I forgot because, well, it's one single treasure chest in there, and all the other treasure chests, I can't remember the exact requirements for every single one off the top. Oh, are you kidding me already? Like, come on. Is that it? Okay. No? Oh my goodness. Oh, so many of those guys around. Oh my god, are you infinite? Are you infinite? Is there gonna be another one of you? Ah, okay. I'm gonna just sit here and farm money off of you. And then they stop when I say that, of course. Anyway, since we couldn't get anything... okay, we got two pieces of heart there, here, but... We are now going to head to... let's see... Ah, here we go, Stonewatcher Island. This is where we're heading to next. Okay, if I am correct in my remembering... This is where I foolishly died. Remember that several episodes ago when I attempted to hit those cannons with the boomerang and they all proceeded to just annihilate me? Yeah. Well, we're back! And we have something that can actually fight them this time. That is not close enough. Oh shoot, down, down, down. There we go. I just need to go. Oh, come on. He just... No, that poor Bokoblin. He did not stand a chance. There we go. Just destroy this cannon as well. What are they even firing at? I'm not over there! They don't even know who I am! They're like... King of Atlantis, can you please turn... Okay. Can I... please? Okay. It wasn't letting me turn around. Yeah, they don't know where I'm at. They're like, just fire everything. Eventually, maybe you'll hit him. Compared to how they were earlier. Okay, stop. King of Atlantis, stop. Let's see, can I do this? I need to head out a little bit. Okay, let's see here. Okay, yeah, can't miss this really. And with that, that is what I wanted the first time we were here. I was kind of foolish, tried to attack the things with a boomerang just to see if it could work, and it didn't, and I literally paid for my trying to get this with my life, which is really ironic given what I'm about to get. You can pretty easily guess it, can't you? Goodbye. Okay. And the thing I paid for my life with trying to get was life itself. Yep. Ironic, but that also sounded kind of poetic the way I said it, didn't it? Anyways. Okay. Now that I got that, finally, it's time to head off to someplace else. Because I still can't do anything on that island over there. Okay. It started there as soon as I landed from warping in. So I was just like, okay, since I'm pretty much on top of it, thanks to the game putting me on top of it, I can go and get a silver ruby. Sweet! Which is awesome because we're not really here at Dragon Roost for anything specific. We're literally just here for some money, really. That's pretty much it. What we want to do first is we want to go, and as you can see over there, there are... Ouch! There is pain. And there is... Also, let's see... What we need to do is we just need to go and hit this. Oh, come on, that was close enough. I can see the arrows. I've literally hit around the bomb plant. Come on, come on. Too low. Too low. There we go. And that's all that I was trying to do. And with this, we open up a treasure chest and get another silver ruby. Anyways, on the back of Dragon Roost Island, we have this place that was too far away. We had this rock here that was too far away to go and blow up with a bomb flower when we were forced to. And it leads to a hidden cave. And I do believe this one actually lets me get its reward already. What awaits us inside this kind of arena-like place? A single pot for starters. With money. Anyways, we have several ways in and out of here. All of which have enemies within. And with that, this door has now opened! And with that, we see a treasure chest. And what's in this treasure chest? A purple ruby. I mean, it's not as good as the silver rupees I just got. But, well, we have some more money here. And that's always nice. So there we go, 863 is a lot better than the, like, 34 I had near the start of this episode. Okay, here we go. That one took like 15 tries. This is just off the coast of Dragon Roost Island to the east, and this treasure is a purple ruby. Always nice to get. Anyways, onward and on forth. Anyways, we have reached a man-made structure out in the ocean. And, fish, what do you have to say to us this time? Besides that you can't go fighting evil on a diet, can't go fighting evil hungry, or on a diet. Okay, what do we have here? We have I mean, I know the name of it, but I'm waiting to say it until it comes up on the map. For it is the flight control platform. To the west of here, over on Dragonroost Island, you'll see all kinds of rocks. Big ones, little ones, you get the picture. Anyway, they say that long ago, there used to be treasure hidden inside those things. Who knows? There may be some left. Not anymore. Oh, there we go. Anyways, we are going to get to the flight platform here and then end the episode because it's been going on for a bit long enough, I feel. And I don't know exactly how long it's going to be once I edit everything out, but I feel it's going to be a bit long, but... Oh, hey, cutscene. Yeah, it's not too much, but there is a mini game here. Let's see, what does it say? Birdman contest. Side encounter. If you think you were born to fly, then take the challenge of the sky to win fame and prizes. Oh, that was nice. And what do you have to say, old man Ho Ho? Ho ho! All the way out there? Oh, I see, quite so. Oh, anyways. Hello there, mailbox. You're with Inside Dragon Roost, very much so. Anyways, this is Gordablaze, and I will see you all next time when we continue to take. When we first do the Boatman contest, and then continue to explore the Great Sea. Anyways, I will see you all next time. So long, everyone.